Hey everybody, Rorree here. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm coming to you with an oracle and tarot reading for the collective. So it's for everybody, whoever resonates with. These readings are timeless. I feel like whenever you come upon a reading, it's meant for you to come upon that reading, no matter when it was recorded. I feel like that is your time. When you come upon it, that was your time to see it. So these readings are timeless. I used a couple different oracle decks, and then I used a tarot deck to pull these cards. And those of you who know, I am not well-versed with tarot. I'm just learning tarot, you know, and it has been a fun journey. So I'm intuitive. I'm an intuitive healer, medical intuitive, empath, and, you know, I heal with my hands and, you know, all that good stuff. And I found that the cards kind of clarify what I hear sometimes. They could, like, I might hear something and the cards might help whatever I hear be a little bit more specific. And things of that nature. So anyway, so I started using cards recently while working with clients, and I'm having a lot of fun doing it. You know, I used to hate it. But anyway, so let me get into this so that we're not here all day. All righty. So the first card that I pulled is guidance. It's a young lady here, and this is guidance. Okay. And so this young lady is sitting here and she's actually looking at a tarot deck. And what cards did she pull? The star card, the moon card, and something else. I don't know what that last card is. No, the sun, the moon, and the star. All right. And she's sitting there and she's looking at these cards. And what does she have in her hand? Maybe that's the deck of cards. I don't know. But anyway, she's sitting there, and what I get from this card, as well as from the rest of the reading, because there was some confirmation in the reading that guidance is needed, is that it's for you guys that are watching and for you who resonate with what you're hearing, it's time for you to get some guidance, some spiritual guidance. So if you use cards to get guidance for yourselves, do that. You could just pray and meditate, ask your ancestors, guides, and angels to talk to you, speak to you loudly and clearly so that you know it is them and so that you know what it is that they're trying to tell you. But it's time to get some spiritual guidance. Now, be careful where you go to ask for guidance, because not everybody has the right to speak into your lives, and not everybody will know how to speak into your lives, okay? So just be careful on where you go for guidance. Maybe this is your guidance. Who the hell knows? I don't know. Hopefully I'm able to give you some guidance here, okay? But now it's time to be still, get some guidance. So you may want to do some meditation. You may want to do some journaling and just journal whatever thoughts come to you. Pray and then journal, you know, do some cards. You know, I like to do cards daily for myself, you know, and I have all different kinds of cards that I would do for myself. I've even produced some cards, the prosperity formula, and I will shuffle the cards and then maybe I'll pick out one or three, and then I will read the card out loud and speak it out as though I am calling in whatever it is that I've read on that card. So whatever you do to tap into your higher self and to get some spiritual guidance, do that, because it's time for you to get some guidance. And then there are two cards, and I'm going to read what they said. I was asking for one and two came out. So the first one that came out is called Satya. I feel like I've heard some of these words when I chant. So the first card that came out is called Satya. Let me show you what it looks like. That's what it looks like. Very pretty card. All right, so this card looks like a woman that's doing some type of meditation practice or some type of practice, and she's outside, and it looks like she is taking in the energy of her surroundings. That's what this card looks like to me. It looks like she is absorbing energy from the sun, from the land, just from the whole earth. It seems like that she's just gathering in the light and the energy, the greens and the beautiful colors and the flowers, and she's just absorbing it all. So let's see what this means. Okay, so truthfulness. All right, so it says, you are moving towards your truth, peeling off all layers of inauthenticity that have been placed upon you by societal conditioning. I hope when I messed up, I didn't throw y'all off. Okay. Through this shedding, you are finally feeling truth's bare skin as you place your fingers upon your face, finally coming home to yourself. This truth, Satya, has been dormant inside you for a long time, waiting until your awakening. And this is so small, I'm like struggling even with glasses on. Maybe I need to get my eyes checked. Anyway, through this process of understanding, unlearning, and evolving, you become a Bodhi, awakened person. So a Bodhi is awakened person. Continue to step into the new paradigm of truth as you shed all false beliefs, narratives, and stories so you can emerge as your true self, ask yourself. I'm sorry. Okay. Ask yourself, where and how can I show up more authentically in my life? What makes me feel like I'm living in my truth? Are my relationships in alignment with who I am at this moment? What mask am I still wearing to make me feel loved, secure, or significant? Truthfulness. Wow, is that what this reading is talking about? Wow. Okay. All right. Living your truth. Truthfulness. Okay. All right. So now I understand this reading. So I didn't really, I was like, who, what's going on here? Okay. So that's truthfulness. Okay. So now let's read Rahas. Okay, let's see. And I'm gonna read that truthfulness again to myself later. Okay, and I hope I can read this one a little better. Okay. Dynamic movement, aggression, and energy. All right, so those are the keywords for Rahas. Oh, let me show you the picture. All right, so this is Rahas. So it looks like a woman. Looks like a melanated colored woman. Someone with melanin in their skin. There's a sun there. There's like a landscape or something behind her with bright lights sparkling. There's a tiger in the picture. Beautiful colors. I really don't know what this means. But dynamic movement, aggression, energy. Okay, so let's read it. All right. You are in a place of movement, making the most of each day. You're passionate and excited about the tasks at hand and are pushing the limits of what you believe possible for yourself. Raha, I think that's how you pronounce it, or Rahas, I don't know. Or Raja, maybe it's Raja. I don't know. Anyway, is needed to bring our desires into action. And you are deep in the development phase. You have already achieved many great accomplishments because of your determination, and more await in the near future. However, remember to balance action with rest. Otherwise, you will lose sight of your true goal in the pursuit of achieving more. All right. So we don't want to get too ego-driven while we're moving forward on this process, on our journeys, all right? And we want to live our truth. So you want to get some spiritual guidance to make sure you're walking in your truth and not walking in vain desires or in your ego driven desires. You know, nothing wrong with having an ego, but you don't want to walk with that forward because you may just run all over people. All right. So now I kind of understand what this reading is talking about here. All right. So I'm going to go into the tarot part of this reading now. So the card, I'm just going to go through what I'm getting from these cards. So some of you, whoever relates to this information, are you're on a journey, you're on your path, and you've had a lot of adversity. You've had a lot of stuff thrown at you, but a lot of that is behind you, and you're kind of, you've moved past that. But although you've moved past it, it's still kind of gnawing at you as you move forward. And you're needing spiritual guidance. You definitely have to tap into your higher self. You have to tap into your Rorree, tap into God, ask your soul group to help you to know which way to go, to know what foot to put forward, you know, on this path. On your path, you could have trampled over some people. You could have stomped on others to get to where you want to go. Or some others could have stomped on you to get to where they want to go. All right. On this journey, you got to be very mindful of how you're moving. I'm feeling like some of you, you've gone through a lot. You have been taken advantage of. It hasn't been the greatest for you. It's been a lot of struggle. You have worked, you have used everything within you. You've used your creative juices. You have poured out your heart. You know, that's for some of you. Some of you, you've taken advantage of somebody else. But for some of you, you've poured out your heart, and it's time to take control of what's going on in your life and to step into newness. But as you step into newness, you feel like you've encountered hell. You know, you feel like everybody stabbed you in the back. You know, you feel like maybe a victim or martyr or something like that. But I feel like you have to take a different perspective as to what's going on in your life. I know that a lot of you don't really know exactly where you're going or what's happening, but you're moving forward regardless. You're doing the little things every day in a great day, regardless of what you've had to endure. You're like, you got your big girl panties on, you're just taking it all in stride, you're moving through the punches. You know, sometimes you feel like, I think I'm through this, but I ain't sure. I still feel like there's a little struggle there, or you might be over that now. You know, some of you, you may be past the struggle. Some of you, you're at the end of the struggle and you felt it. You know what I mean? It's like you got a shirt on and a shirt has like holes in it from daggers, you know, and you're wearing this shirt, you know, And some of you, I feel like you wear it proudly. Some of you like being a victim. So you like taking that victim stance. I'm not saying that that's good or bad, but that's just where some of you are. But it's time to really look at things differently and not be the victim of your circumstances, but be the victor of your life experiences and this journey that you've been on, because you really are coming out victorious, whether you've been stabbing people in the back or they've been stabbing you. You know, either way, you're coming through that. You're overcoming that. I feel like your ancestors, guides, and your angels are working with you to help develop you into the best you that you can possibly be. Whether yesterday you were that rough rider, that person that didn't give a damn, or whether you were that person that got knocked out, or they try to knock you out, I should say, because nobody's knocked out here. No matter which person you've been, if you've been the one that wants to be the martyr or the victim, you know, then forgive yourself for wanting to be a victim or enjoying being a victim. If you were the one victimizing people and you were the bully, and now you've gotten some guidance and you're moving through that, you're not bullying people anymore, you know, forgive yourself for how you showed up, all right? I feel like forgiveness is needed on either end of this spectrum here, but you're being led, you're being guided. So follow the guidance, even if you can't see what's happening tomorrow. Because what's happening tomorrow is that there are people out there to help you, all right? You may have been struggling financially, you may have been struggling in some kind of way, but there's somebody there to help you. And they're there to help you to have this, to have your desires of your heart, to have financial success, financial abundance, to have the family that you desire, to have the success in your relationships that you desire. That's the outcome, is for you to have that. No matter what side of that coin you were on, you know what I mean? Whether you were stealing something from somebody. Okay? Or not. Or whether you were the victim of that. Getting all stabbed up, left for dead. All right. So whichever you were, make sure you receive that spiritual guidance. Live in your truth. If you don't like what your truth has been, reinvent yourself. You know? But do it unapologetically, because you are who you are and you're where you are on purpose for a reason. So no regrets. Everything is as it's supposed to be. Everything that's happened in your life happened on purpose. If you don't like something, work on it, change it. If you like who you are, live unapologetically you, okay? That's why my channel is called Totally Rorree. Because I'm going to live unapologetically, totally Rorree. I'm going to be exactly who I am. However you like it, good, bad, indifferent, I don't care. I'm going to be totally me, and that's what I want. I want you to be totally you. So you guys, I hope y'all enjoyed that reading for today. It was quite interesting to me. Quite interesting to look at the different perspectives, but wonderful to see the outcome. Wonderful. All right, y'all. Enjoy your day. Ashe. Oh, like, subscribe, comment, share. At least like, okay? All right. Ashe.